10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
All her peeps. So at the time of this filming, it is December 14th. So this is the fourth day of Hanukkah. So if you guys are celebrating Hanukkah, happy Hanukkah to you. I'm super excited to be bringing this movie to you guys. It is a Jewish movie called The Vigil. It has nothing to do with Hanukkah. It is, however, religious horror. And you guys know how I am about religious horror. So I'm super, 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 super excited to be being able to review this for you guys. So if you want to know what I think, stick around after the trailer. Okay, you guys, let's get into this.
Vergewaltigt ist das besonders schäumig. Am Nacht.
In the other show, I mean, why was he leaving?
Ah, der schäumig ist das. Das ist nicht normal. Er hat mir gesagt, ein Mann Sprüche. Er hat Meure.
Meure?
Der Chef in Kedisha, du sahen in Film of Show. Er geht sein, der schäumig, du hat Nacht.
He needs to leave now.
Sign it still? Mrs. Litvak? Mrs. Litvak. Mrs. Litvak!
Do you want some tea?
Now.
It won't let you leave.
What won't let me leave?
If you run out, the magic will make you crawl right back.
What in the world? The problem is you need money and he knows it. Yep. He's gonna have to. Mm-hmm. That should be your first clue. Don't do it. Don't do it. And the reason he did that to you is because you're broke. Here we go. There's a reason why he ran out of the house. You're not asking the right questions. Listen to her. Yep, back the fuck up out. What? Wait, who else is in the house? Leave, just leave. She said leave. Where are you going? What in the world? She's going to bed, so guess what? You're stuck there. You should have left. She's going to bed, so guess what? You're stuck there. You should have left. What did I get myself into? It's $100 an hour. That's not too bad. How did you hear that over your music? Is that the wife? No, because the bedroom's on the other side. What? Yep, you're supposed to be praying over the dead body to protect him. Start praying right now. Keep going, don't stop. Keep going. That would make me uncomfortable. What in the whole entire world. Get out of the house. What? Oh! Yeah, nope. Where did it go? You know what? I would need a Xanax, and I don't even have anxiety. It's so important. What is going on in this house? Obviously, wait, what's happening? You need to keep praying. You have the Torah in your hand. Nope, it is time. It's time to get out of the house. Just go get that woman from upstairs and go outside, okay? She told you you shouldn't be there anyway. 4 more hours to go. What is this? I'm sorry. What is this? You need to be praying, okay? Don't go to sleep. Nope, you're gonna go to sleep. Okay. I'm sorry, what in the world? You're not supposed to be sleeping. What? See? What is this? Oh no. You need to be praying. You need to be praying. Did this body just move? Stop biting your nails. I told you. Put that fucking phone down and start praying. There's a reason why this ritual is important. See? You need to pay attention to the signs. Dude. Oh my god. You're not paying attention. You're not doing what you're supposed to do. Okay? You left the community, which is fine, but you agreed to do a community ritual and you need to be taking it seriously. Dude, get off your fucking phone. He's not going to get bored because what he was supposed to be doing, he's not doing, and so now evil is in. Now there's no lights. Are you fucking kidding me? You blew it. You need to be praying, dude. This is important. That's why there's a ritual. See? Who is this? Who took the picture? Oh my. See? See? What I mean? This is your phone. Who's in the fucking house with you? You shouldn't have been asleep. You shouldn't have been asleep. Oh, really? How did he sleep through this? How? No, it wasn't her. You should have been praying. You should have been fucking paying attention. You shouldn't have been asleep. You should have been on your fucking phone. Don't go up there. Just pray. Just fucking pray. Do what you're supposed to be doing. That's or either leave. What in the fuck, dude? You know what? There's the door. Turn around and walk out of it. Who is this? Start praying. See, you know what? Fucking leave. Just leave. Just leave. Okay. What's going on is the evil is in because you weren't doing what you were supposed to be doing. You're not losing your fucking mind. You're not. Okay? Why did you agree to take this job if you weren't going to do it? What's going on with you is not psychological. It's spiritual. It's because you're a non-believer. You messed this all up. You used to... You knew what you were supposed to be doing and you didn't. This is what's going on, okay? You're not having a psychological break. This is spiritual.
Sorry about the mess.
Listen to what she's saying to you. For the money. But you're not doing the job. He's not a believer. He is a believer, but what? It's worse than that, because he used to believe. And there was a reason for that. Are you going to ask for why?
You know why.
In her moments of fucking clarity, you need to be paying attention. Who's down there? Just, you know what? Don't investigate. Just close and lock that door. Don't go down there. I told you, don't go down there. You don't fucking listen. She said it was a bunker. Just close the door. Why? No one ever listens. You're gonna... He's not paying attention. He's just not paying attention. Go upstairs and set that fucking body on fire, okay? He's telling you what to do. That's you. Go up there and set that body on fire. Oh my God. What is happening? Behind you. Turn around. Oh my God. Hurry up. Jesus H. Christ of Nazareth, did it bite you? Set that body on fire, okay? Because he told you what you have to do. Oh my God. Why are you going back down there? Just close and lock that fucking door. Like, what? What? Oh, close the door. Is that your doctor or Sarah? That's not the doctor. You're nowhere near safe, dude. Nowhere near it. They are real, dude. This is not psychological, okay? See? That's not your doctor. If you're not gonna leave that house, and if you're not gonna start praying, then you need to set everything on fucking fire like he told you to do. Hang up the phone! Hang up the phone. Just hang it up. You know what? This is nuts. That's not her! Get out of the house. Get out. No. What's happening? Get that woman and leave the fucking house. Just take her with you. Just go. Just go. Just go. Just leave. 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 Why are we still having this conversation? The door is just right there. Just leave. Leave her there. She's not leaving. She's not leaving, dude. Leave her! You will be back, but not for the reasons you think. Dude, you should have been playing from the beginning, but you didn't, so now here we are. Call whoever you're supposed to be calling, okay? Where's your phone? What's going on? You said you were gonna call somebody. Oh! Damn it! Right there, so close to help, and you can't even scream. Damn it! Just, if you can just stay there. Nope, who is this? There it is. Damn it. Damn it. Oh, man. Just like she said. Oh, just like she said. Look at it. The closer he gets to the house, the better he feels. You know what you should do? You should stand right where you are and pick up your phone and call for help. That's like the little sweet spot where you're at right now. Okay? Nope, that's not what you're gonna do. I told you not to leave. I told you to use your phone. See? Just stay outside then. Just get on the, call somebody. I don't understand. Just use the. This is stressful. This is so stressful. Just sit on the stairs outside and call for help. You're fucked now, dude. Right back in the, how did he get up the stairs? And who bandaged his hand? The rabbi's wife. No, you didn't. Do not carry that fucking guilt with you. Because you were terrified. Fucking hell. No, you didn't, dude. That's not your burden. That's not your burden. Man. Where is the body? He's like, whatever. What? No, he, no, go outside. Hang up your phone. This is not your little girlfriend. This is the demon who's interfering with your phone calls. Hang up the phone. This is not your burden. What is going on? That's not Sarah. Do not go upstairs. Sit your ass right there until all those rabbis come back. Okay, what? Or at least just go outside the front door, maybe. What is this? Like, what? Who's under the sheet? You are. Okay, you know what? Just, oh my God. That's not your little brother, dude. And he didn't, okay? He didn't let you die. There was nothing that he could do. You know what? Just talk to him. Maybe that's your key to get out. You need to forgive yourself because in that situation, you didn't do anything wrong. Don't go upstairs. Okay? Sit your fucking ass back in that chair. You have a half hour left. Okay? He said that they'll be back at 5:30. Oh my God. Don't. Oh my. Don't. Okay, well, fuck. You don't fucking listen. No one ever does. No one ever does. Really? You're just gonna go into someone's bedroom and not knock first? She's not there. And if she is there, it's not her. This whole situation is just so fucked up. You know that's not real. This is incredible. This is so incredible. Oh my God. Keep praying. Just pray. What is going on? What is going on? There he is. Okay, so keep praying. You need to forgive yourself. Because you keep looking into the past. This is why you're afflicted. Just breathe through it. Okay, you're wearing the full armor of God. You're okay here. Yes. Whew. That's what you need to do. Oh, okay. Are we okay? First of all, you would give me my $500. Fuck all that. Are we okay? He's not even tripping. He's like, whatever, you're dying now. Now pray over his body so his soul can be released. Okay. No wonder. That's his fucking wife. Oh, wow. Wow. Oh, fuck. She's free. Now, are you? You can do it. I beat his fucking ass. Are you kidding me? You have to pay me $8,000 because that's some bullshit right there. I beat his fucking ass. Are you fucking kidding? Fuck you if you knew what was gonna happen.
Back to your love as I will hide on.
Keep going. Just keep going. I thought you only drink tea. Is this how it ends, you guys? Wait, who's coming out behind them? He just set everybody free. Oh my god. You guys? This was incredible. Incredible. Like, okay. So this is the second Jewish horror movie that I've seen. The first one I think we all seen from 2012 called The Possession. Now that one, the 2012 movie, Possession, did revolve around a Jewish family. And it was basically a traditional possession movie, kind of like if you were to take The Exorcist and put it in a Jewish setting. There's a lot not to like about that movie. One of the things that irked me was that the rabbi in that film, in the 2012 film Possession, he looked like he wasn't even 40 years old. And so, not old enough to really, like, perform a full-blown exorcism all by himself. This movie is about a possession, but what possesses the soul of the dead? So we have a Yokef who has left the Jewish community, and he's in a support group with other Jewish people who have left the community because it seems like the tight-knit Orthodox community has different rules and different ways of doing things. It's like, and I don't know if it's a fair comparison, but listening in on the group therapy session, it seems like it would be like an Amish kid trying to like leave the community and start a whole life in modern day society, not knowing how to use a phone and not knowing how people pick up on, you know, other people hitting on them, flirting with them, and just not being able to function really well. So that's what this, what he's going through, right? And so he's left the community, and one of the rabbis has been trying to recruit him back into the community. So after a group meeting, he's waiting outside for him, and he's like, you know, I know you're struggling for money. I need you to perform a vigil. And so in the Jewish community, when someone dies, there is a person who sits and prays with the body all night long to ensure that the body, the soul, is not consumed by a demon or evil, right? So what his job was to do was to sit and pray by the body for 4 hours. And the only reason he took the job is because he needed money. And so as the movie unfolds itself, you find out that the demon that is possessing the soul of the person who died is a demon who eats on guilt and pain. And Yokef is also going through a lot of pain because when he was still living in the Jewish community, people outside of the community killed his brother. And because he was not familiar with the violence of society and the things that happen outside of the protection of his community, he didn't know what to do. And so he was blaming himself for his brother's death. It wasn't his fault at all. The man who died, he was a Holocaust survivor. And he was forced to do something while he was a prisoner, and it was horrific. It was horrific. And so the demon that is featured in this movie is a demon that has his head faced backwards because he's always looking into the past. And so the man died, the Holocaust survivor died, and the new, the guy who, Yokev, he was supposed to be doing the vigil, they both had similar life experiences, but they both dealt with grief the same way. They kept looking back into the past. They couldn't find a way to forgive themselves. They couldn't find a way to work around the pain that they were going through to, like, move forward, right? And so the demon was excited that Yokev came in because he was another broken soul, and so he was just going to, possess his body and live within this kid for, like, however many long years he had left to live, which is probably about 60. And so the man's wife is telling Yokev what happened, not really what happened, but, like, what's going on. They had filmed this, I don't want to give too much away, but anyway, at the end, when he goes to battle the demon, it's really interesting because, again, he turned his back on his faith in the community, but she gave him, the skull cap that Jewish men wear, and she also gave him these two blocks, and I don't know what it is, but hopefully I won't. Two blocks strapped with leather, and so one he wrapped around his left hand, and the other one he wrapped around his forehead and neck and back. And so for me, watching him do that, it was like watching a priest put on his purple stole before he does an exorcism. And it was, I think it's meant to be the same way, because when he put that on, you know, he was like donning the full armor of God. And so he went to save the soul of the man who had died, and he did what he needed to do. It was so good. I love this movie. I'm super glad that I was able to watch it for you guys. I hope you guys get to watch it too. It's getting 5 stars. It's just, I liked it way better than Possession, because it wasn't trying to be an exorcism movie. This is absolutely based on their culture and the vigil. I can't, they say it a couple of times in the movie, but I don't know how to pronounce it. But the English way to say it is the vigil. It's so good. It's so good, you guys. So I hope everything is well. Again, we're in the middle of Hanukkah. Happy Hanukkah for those of you who celebrate it. And thanks for hanging out with me and Horror Addicts, and I'll see you on their next review. Okay, guys. Bye.